Well, they started a couple of minutes after the start of Nelson Oliveira. He's inside the final few hundred metres. He will be going to the top of the leaderboard. This is a blistering time by Remy Cavagna. It will be somewhere in the vicinity of 40 to 45 seconds quicker than the next best amongst the early starters. He's not losing his composure. He is rattling and rolling. He's desperately trying to keep it straight and get the shortest line through to the finish line. He is rolling across the road. He's turning 100 metres into about 105. He just needs to charge through to the finish line as Cavagna is stopping the clock at the top of the leaderboard. As he fades through to the finish, he gets there in a time of 37.55, 35 seconds quicker than his nearest rival with an average speed of 49.2. That is quick. The winner of last year's Tour de France, Jonas Vingegaard, is underway. This is the benchmark on board with Ben O'Connor.
Now, Ben O'Connor out on the road. The big hope here for Western Australia, for Australia, for the AG Tour Citroen team. Now, Ben O'Connor, he has been working a lot in his individual time training. We can work that out sheer by his progression over the past couple of years.
Well, Henley, he slowed significantly between the first checkpoint and the second checkpoint. It was at 18 seconds. It's now out to 33 seconds. And Jack Haig is closing in on that same checkpoint. He started 1 minute after Jai Hindley rolling down the ramp, and he will almost have Hindley within his sights, which will be putting Cavagna and Martinez also within his sights. This is now Jonas Vingegaard coming through to the second checkpoint. He was the quickest by 12 seconds at the first checkpoint. Remy Cavagna has ridden brilliantly. From checkpoint one to checkpoint two, Remy Cavagna has been 13 seconds faster than Jonas Vingegaard. But Vingegaard is still riding with a chance to win the stage. 1 second off the pace with the climb to come to the finish line. Mikhail Biao is flying. He's now tracking at 14 seconds to the better of Remy Cavagna.
And look how aero, and he's not just aero, he's in fact his elbows are lower, so he's almost at a downward angle with his upper body, his rib cage. If his head was tucked down even further, you can see Cavagna there.
It's not
he's been
over
sitting
yet,
there
Remy.
For some time though, hasn't he?
Indeed he has. It's not over yet. A lot can happen in the last 4Ks. This is Jai Hindley with an outstanding individual time trial. This is one of the best performances Hindley has ever put in against the clock. He will not beat the time of Remy Cavagna, but it'll be the first so far amongst the Aussies. There's a lot to smile about for Hindley. And he can see the finish line and he can see the time. It's 37.55 that he is looking for. Cavagna has spent a long, long time in the hot seat. He's about to find the exit door because the big Dane, the triple under 23 world time trial champion, is mowing down the time of Remy Cavagna, who's picking up his belongings and ready to leave the hot seat. One last burst for Mikhail Biao, sprinting to the finish line, 37.28. New best time, an average speed of almost 50 kilometres per hour. Extraordinary. Here comes Ben O'Connor. Is Ben O'Connor going to prove to be the best of the Australians? Luke Durbridge was at 1:08 behind, and Ben O'Connor is going to be inside that. The form is good approaching the Tour de France for O'Connor. He is in third position, 41 seconds. He'll be pleased. And here comes Jonas Vingegaard. So he has faded a little over the second part of the course. It was a blistering start. He was 12 seconds faster than anybody else across the first 10 kilometres. But measuring the effort is crucial in any individual time trial. Mikhail Biao has knocked off Jonas Vingegaard, so he stays at the top of the table. And you can see Jonas is suffering all the way to the line, second on the start, stage with the tank on empty at 12.7 seconds. And he will be taking the yellow jersey off the shoulders of Christophe Laporte. Laporte has been brilliant in the Dauphiné. He's still got a big role to play in support of Jonas Vingegaard. He's just outside the top 20. It has been a solid performance. Laporte, dual stage winner, is no longer the race leader because the Dane, Mikhail Biao, has gone to the top of the table. Mikhail Biao wins the stage and takes the maillot jaune.